I'm very pleased to open this meeting on new approaches in weather forecasting. We never had such a meeting, and it's really important for us. There is a gem, a big gem in the Ayalon from the north, so some of the participants are still didn't arrive, including the chair for this session. So I will start. When Nir Stav arrives, he will continue. I wish to start with the greetings. And first, I wish to thank Joanna Landau, who is not here. Daniel Marcus' sister, that brought this idea to do something important for the weather forecasting community in Israel in memory of Daniel. Linda and Ellie Streit then took this opportunity to perhaps fulfill a dream of Daniel, being as a shift leader in Hebrew, Rosh Mishmeret Sofim. Is that correct, Uri? You were the boss. Okay. And Memayin Sofim, which is a shift leader, I guess. This is the right wording. In the Air Force Meteorological Combat Service Unit. I happened to be in the Air Force doing reserve as a forecaster in 1993. When we were informed that Daniel was killed in a road accident. The first Johanna's idea was to do something with clouds. And she told me Daniel always loved and mentioned clouds. Then we reached jointly the idea of bringing forecasting research leaders in the world to Israel, in order to excite the forecasting research community. They absolutely need it in Israel. I'm very pleased and wish to deeply thank our three most distinguished visitors, who are really leaders, world leaders in this topic. First, Veronica Zwas-Meise, the head of the Synoptic Group Department in Austria, in Vienna, an expert on forecasting different algorithms. We saw yesterday the enthusiasm in which your talk was accepted by the forecasters. Then Lou Cellini, director of the United States National Centers for Environmental Prediction. And I will talk more about Louis in my talk. All kinds of debates that we had in NASA. And Tom Warner, I would say a father of one of the first mesoscale models. It used to be called MM4 when you did your PhD, was it? MM1. I never heard about MM1. It became known to the community worldwide when it became MM4, I think. And then MM5, which until recently was a leading mesoscale model in the world, and now it's the Wolf. We'll hear more about it in Tom Warner's talk. And this, Tom, is from the United States National Center of Atmospheric Research and a professor at the University of Colorado. We already saw and heard yesterday at the Israel Meteorological Service from our guest speakers about the most modern tools for forecasting and research. And this includes many ideas. Some of these ideas have already been implemented, and some not yet, in the process. on the new approaches in weather forecasting that are very important to be implemented in Israel in the coming decade. I'm sure we'll get the help of you, of all three visitors. Tom Warner already works with the Air Force, with the Israeli Air Force, on the new mesoscale modeling system, the WOV. Personally, we are very much interested to work closely also with LU and the ANSEP in order to develop an efficient use of the ensemble weather predictions in Israel with the GFS system from ANSEP. As Lou said yesterday several times, this is the most important thing in the near future, the ensemble weather forecast predictions. And we are sure this is so. But we are lagging a lot behind. I am sure also that the Israel Meteorological Service is much interested in enhancing these collaborations. And particularly, I heard with Veronica's wonderful algorithms, very useful for the forecasters. Before I give the place to Linda to do the greetings, I cannot refrain from bringing something from our tradition on the most hottest forecasting question in Israel these days. I'm telling it for you. Everybody knows. And the most important question, forecasting question in Israel today is, how good will be the rainfall in the coming winter? Veronica told me it's a nice day today. Not for the forecaster community. If it was raining, it was a nice day for us. And my personal hope, and many in Israel, I'm sure in this community, that the Israel Meteorological Service forecast brought to us yesterday in the afternoon in Hebrew, you missed it, for another below average winter, we all hope that it will be wrong, including the ANSEP prediction. It will be wrong. This is our hope. And I want to bring support for this hope from the Talmud, Tractate Baba Batra. They are discussing on this topic, how do we know if the winter is going to be a good winter or with a lot of rain, above average or below average? And in the Talmud, there are three different opinions. One says we have to look on the day, on the holiday of Pentecost. I think Shavuot is Pentecost, is correct, okay. The other day is on the day of the new year. You look about the temperature of the new year, which happened about a month and a half ago. And the third opinion is you have to look on the last day of Sukkot. By the way, it's in the book. Those who wish to know more details, they can look it in my book. Tabernacles, right. So the third opinion is that we have to look on the last day of Sukkot, perhaps Simchat Torah, and see where the wind blows. Actually, this happens nearly almost always in October. And the main tool for the Israel Meteorological Service, this is very strange, happens to be looking in October average weather for predicting the following winter. So it works. The third idea in the Talmud still works. You can find more details in my book, Geshem Baruach, which is rainfall and wind. So, according to this opinion, we probably are going to have above the average winter. So, I hope this is what is going really to happen. And finally, I wish us all a very interesting and also very productive meeting today for the forecasting community and to honor the memory of Daniel Amichai Marcus. And I will also mention grandmother is here, Shirley Porter, who is the founder of the school that I am currently heading, the Porter School of Environmental Studies. So we look forward very much for a very interesting and productive day. Thank you very much. I want to ask Linda Streit to give her greetings.